can hold them off. Go back and get Alenko. You know it's the right choice, LT. That won't happen. Go get him, Commander. I'll see you all when you get back. Whatever you come up with, you can count me in.
It's open.
Shepard, there's something you need to hear.
All right.
Is this a bad time?
Thinking of some friends who weren't around thanks to this war.
That's thanks to the Reapers, not you. Are you thinking about anyone in particular?
Ashley back on Vermeer. She gave her life stopping Sovereign. I wonder what she'd make of fighting a whole fleet of Reapers.
If I had to guess, Ashley would call it target practice.
Yeah. Sounds like her. Didn't you have something for me?
The Solarian Counselor has an urgent matter.
Let me guess. He called the comm room.
The Council must be taking the Crucible seriously. I'll see you downstairs.
Commander, there is something we should discuss if you are finished rewriting history.
I made my decision, Counselor. There's not much anyone can do about it now.
Yes. We're going to have billions more Krogan in the galaxy. It's a good thing you saved my life once, Shepard. Otherwise, well, I have concerns about humanity's representative, Counselor Udina. My agents have discovered that he's using his authority to move vast sums of money. For what purpose? We're not sure.
If Udina's dirty, it's best we get to the bottom of it fast.
Agreed. Come to the Citadel. We will review the evidence and discuss this in private. Thalern out.
Commander, Admiral Hackett's available on VidCom.
Commander Shepard, something you need to talk about?
What's our state of readiness, Admiral?
I won't lie, Shepard. We're bogged down. Things aren't looking good in most sectors. We need to increase the tempo and chalk up some wins, otherwise this won't end well for the human race, or any race.
What about the extra help we picked up along the way?
The Krogan and Turians have obviously been a big help. Erdnut Rex running the show is a bonus for us. And that female Krogan you rescued is rallying more support from the other clans. I'm glad you disabled that mom and T'Chunka. We could have lost a lot of Krogan support as it is. We picked up some Turian troops.
Good to hear. What about the Rachni?
I wouldn't have believed it, but the Rachni are helping us build the Crucible.
You're kidding.
Turns out they have a knack for weapons of mass destruction. In hindsight, I guess they'd know a thing or two about waging a galactic war.
No problems with them, then?
Other than scaring the hell out of our engineers, no. Not a lot of small talk going on there.
What about Arya's mercenaries?
Arya T'Lok, there's someone I never thought we'd be in bed with. The Blood Pack will be useful and violent. Mostly Vorchai here. We'll put the Blue Suns to good use. Intel says Narnir Vosk is bringing his men, and that they're gunning for a fight. The Eclipse are providing troops and mechs. When we find a Reaper soft spot, they'll help us hit it. Don't want to know how you got Arya's cooperation, but whatever you did, it was worth it.
How about the Salarians?
Interesting wrinkle. We've been getting back channel commitments from the strike teams within STG. They're promising to back us.
Even after I cured the genophage?
Our intel suggests there are cracks developing between the military and the politicians. These STG guys know the score. They're not gonna jeopardize the entire Salarian Union just because some Delatras didn't get her way.
Do you know how the other races are doing against the Reapers?
Believe it or not, the Turians and Krogan actually seem to be getting along. Erdnut Rex has deployed troops, and they're giving the Reapers a moment of pause. The Salarians are still hanging on to Sirkesh, but the Reapers are starting to breathe down their necks, too.
What about the Asari?
They have to be feeling the heat. The Reapers are moving fast with the obvious intent of taking Thessia. Interestingly, the Reapers are leaving Parnak alone. It's the Yogg homeworld.
Can't say that I blame them. Yogg have teeth.
Well, if we lose this war, it might be them running the next cycle. It's easy to forget the Reapers don't destroy every species.
Just the ones who can threaten them. Any word on the Volus and Elcor?
The Turians and the Krogan sent forces to the Volus homeworld, Irun. It might not be enough, but at least they've got Reaper forces bogged down in a nasty ground war. As for Elcor, they're still in the fight, though our projections show the Reapers encroaching on their territory soon.
What happened to the Batarians?
Never stood a chance, hit by the Reapers straight out of the gate. And without any allies to call on, I think the Batarians are history.
Have we heard anything from the Quarians or Geth?
Something might be brewing near the Geth border, but our intel is sketchy. News is getting harder to come by as things get worse.
What about the extra help we picked up along the way?
The Krogan and Turians have obviously been a big help. Erdnut Rex running the show is a bonus for us. And that female Krogan you rescued is rallying more support from the other clans. I'm glad you disabled that mom and T'Chunka. We could have lost a lot of Krogan support as it is. We picked up some Turian troops.
Good to hear. Nothing more, sir.
Keep me posted. Hack it out.
See the bids of the Maw taking down the Reaper? Man, I wish I could have been there.
I'm just glad the diplomats are off the ship.
Commander, Admiral Hackett has requested your help with a Cerberus fighter base on Novaria.
My turn. What's the first order an Alliance commander gives at the start of combat?
I give up.
Correct.
All right, big guy. What do you call it when a Turian gets killed by a horrible spiky monster?
Friendly fire. Come on, that one goes back to Shang-Chi.
You gotta respect the classics.
How many humans does it take to activate a dormant mass relay?
602. 600 to vote on it, one to ask the Asari for technical help, and one to request a seat on the council afterward. How do you know when a Turian's out of ammo?
He switches to the stick up his ass as a backup weapon. Why does the Alliance hire pilots with brittle bone disease?
You're shitting me! The Turian military has one about me?
Oh, absolutely. I heard it myself from a private back on Palavin.
All right, why does the Alliance hire pilots with brittle bone disease?
So their Marines can beat someone in hand-to-hand drills.
Damn, you need to tell James that one. Hey, what's the hardest part about treating a Turian who took a rocket to one side of his face?
Figuring out which side took the rocket.
Never thought I'd see the Krogan and the Turians team up. Even the Reapers have to be a little nervous about pissing them off.
I'd say more than a little.
I'm sorry about Morden.
He was a good man.
Yeah, he was always running those tests. And one time he tagged me in the middle of the night to ask how many livers humans had. And this bump on my elbow? He said it was just a mild bone deformation, but I'm pretty sure he stuck a probe in there.
Glad it was just your elbow.
I always thought he was crazy. Useful, but crazy. Then he gives up his own life.
To save the Krogan. Doesn't do much to disprove the crazy theory, huh?
I guess not. But he was one of ours.
So now that we got the Krogan and the Turians, what now?
The Krogan help us turn the tide on Palavin. They can shoot at something useful for a change.
Dig till we hit daylight, huh? Works for me.
So how does it feel knowing Krogan will be singing songs about you until the end of time? I think it would be an honor.
There's enough misery in this universe. It's nice to see something go right for a change.
Can't say I've ever really witnessed history in the making like this. Well, except for Sovereign attacking the Citadel, and then there was the Collector base, but this one felt good. And let's hope Rex keeps running the show on T'Chanka. Maybe we should hire a food taster for him. Imagine the carnage if someone like that brother of his, Reeve, took over.
That could happen.
I know, it's a chance we have to take, but I have to say, if it wasn't my own world that needed the help, I might have taken that Salarian deal.
I could never bring myself to do that, no matter what I was offered.
I admire your restraint, Shepard. It's nice when we can save the galaxy without destroying another race along the way.
Let's hope our luck holds.